Okay, today we will start with the next module, right? Module 2, lesson 3, that is about the C pointer. As I just told you that the pointer is very important, and also it is also difficult for the people or the students who would like to study the programming language as the first programming language. We cannot avoid using C program because the C programming will be very useful in writing a program for operating system or system programming. For example, if you would like to write an iOS programming, if you would like to write a program for develop the Android, this is also the iOS, that's also the OS for the Android mobile systems. So you need to know how to write a C pointer, okay? And today, so here we now we will check for the list of the topic that we have to study today. Okay, today we will have to talk about what does it mean by pointers and the pointer operator, right? And then we will have to use the pointer for the pass by argument to the function. Actually, this part or this topic we have already started before, but I will review you a bit about this one, right? Why do we have to use the pass by reference or pass by pointer to the function? We will use this kind of function parameter because we want to pass the argument in order to get the value back to this argument, right? For example, if you have a function, right, and you process this function inside the function, and then you have got the result from this function, but maybe you have more than one result, or the result can be written in terms of the complex structure. Complex structure that you cannot return that type to that function alone. So what you have to do is you have to pass by, you have to make the use of pass by reference in order to pass the value back to the argument and then to the actual parameter in the caller program. Okay, this is how to make use the pointer in C programming when you are trying to use it in a function. And we have to study about the close relationships among the pointer, arrays, and string, right? That I will show you in writing some C programs. And then we have to know how to use a pointer to a function and how to define the use array of strings, okay? And this is the list of the outlines that we will talk today. Mm-hmm. So first of all, I would like to start with what does it mean by pointer, right? What does it mean by the pointer? What's happened to my... What's happened to my good note? Update. Okay, so I will start from what? What is pointer? What is a pointer? So actually, when we talk about the pointer, we will have to refer to it about the address to the memory, right? For example, if you like to declare a variable, right? Normally, we will have to, let's say, integer i, right? And I will refer to a memory, right? So you can you can make the use of I by directly use the variable I. For example, if I would like to assign 5 to I, right? I will assign 5 to I like this, that I can use I is equal to 5, and that's all, okay? By this way, you don't need to know the address of A of I, right? But in fact, right, C compiler, we have to define the address of I as well. So, so the simple meaning of the pointer is the address of a variable. Address of a variable. For example, if I start like this, when we use a pointer, it is powerful, even though it is difficult to master or understand, right? And we can use a pointer when we want to simulate call by reference. For example, if I use void, this function, okay, maybe function name, right? And then I want to return a value of something, right? Into this name, right? Value. So I use pointer like this, because I want to change the value here. So value here is a pointer. It's a pointer. For example, in this inside the function, maybe you can change the value of at this address. You can use star or asterisk value. You can set it as 5. So in this way, in the main function, right, you can use this function name. And then when you declare this, maybe you can declare integer I like this, right? And then you send I by using address. Okay, you can see that we have to refer to address like this, because this one star value is a pointer of integer type. So when you send pass by reference here, so this one will send the address of I to this. Okay, and value is a pointer address, or sometimes we can call it address, that point to an integer value. But actually value is a value of integer type. That value is actually pointer value points to. Okay, they are different. Value is actually the pointer, but star value is a value of integer type that the value pointer points to. Maybe I have to change the name value, right, in order to make sure that you will not be confused. Okay, so from the main program, right, you have to use ampersand I in order to refer to the address of I here. Okay, maybe I will have to write the program so you will understand about this, the how to use a pointer clearer. Okay, and the last one, the cross relationship with the array and strings, right? When you use the array, right? Array is one form of pointer, and also the string. String is an array of character, right? And an array of something is also the pointer, right? We can think about it as a pointer. Pointer variables, just definition and initialization. Pointer variables mean or contain memory address of their value. Okay, I've just told you, right? It is a memory address. okay, actually the pointer is a memory address, right? Normal variables contain a specific value. This is a direct reference. Pointers contain address of a variable. See, address of a variable that has a specific value in direct reference. What does it mean by indirect reference? Okay, normal variable, for example, integer x, x is equal to 5. This one is direct reference. Direct reference. But if you declare integer x pointer, okay, I use x pointer, right? And this one is a star, right? So if I want to assign the value to address x pointer, I can use xptr star is equal to 5. This one is indirect reference. Indirect in the sense that x pointer itself is a pointer to integer, right? And star xptr is a value that xptr points to. Okay, it's a value. When you want to invoke to get the value at the address xptr, it means that you are going to refer to it as the indirect reference. And we will call this process as a dereferencing. Dereferencing. Dereferencing is a process that you will get the value from a specific pointer or specific address. Dereferencing is a process. Dereferencing is a process that you will get a value from an address, a specific address, let's say. So maybe it is confusing, right? But if you write a program many times to make the use of the pointer and to use the dereferencing, indirect reference, direct reference, you will get used to it. So my suggestion is that it is a skills that you need to write a program as much as you can do, as many times as you can do. Okay, so indirection, right? Referencing a pointer value. Okay. Okay, this one is a good example, right? So suppose we define count as an integer. Integer count, right? And then what does it mean? It will allocate a space in main memory, right? And you can refer to the value in this memory as the count. Count is a variable. Count is a variable. It's very easy, right? It's very, very easy that you can think about it as a count. But you can also define integer pointer, right? And you refer it as a count pointer. Count pointer like this. So this one is a count. Count pointer is a pointer, right? To an integer. Okay, so in this way, if you want to point the counter here, okay, so in order to when we declare count and count pointer, and then if you want to assign a value to count, you can write a program count is equal to 7. And you want to know the address that count is located, where the count is located. So you can use the count pointer to keep the address, right? By using count pointer is equal to address, right? Address is ampersand, address of count. So this one will refer to the address of count in main memory, and the address will be assigned to the value count pointer. Actually, the pointer is just a value. It's just the location. For example, it's like your address. Like if you are your house is at, okay, this is my house, 100/34. This is my address, my home address. Or if you have the room number A123, right? This is also the address. So this is similar. In C programming, right, we will refer to the address as a value. For example, F2AB, right? It depends on the size of the address, right? If you have, we have the segment and offset. Normally, we will have to use the offset of the address alone, right? When we want to declare the local variable. But sometimes, I'm going to talk about this later on, about if you want to allocate the main memory, not just in the local memory or the same segment. So maybe you have to use the concept of malloc. Malloc means a function that you will allocate the memory in the heap memory. In main memory, we have two kinds of memory. The first one is stack memory, and the second one is heap memory. Okay. So if you want to allocate from the heap memory, you have to use segment and offset. Maybe the size of the address will be longer, 0, 0, 0 for something like this. But if you want to allocate the memory in the stack memory, you may have to use a solid offset that is shorter. So it depends on the compiler. You don't have to worry about that because the compiler will treat this one by yourself. Okay, so in this way, right, if you do like this, right, it will be exactly the same as when we have count, and count will be in this memory, and then you assign 7 to count, 7 will be appear here in the count. But if you want to refer to the address of the count and keep it into the count pointer, right, you have to declare it as integer, and don't forget to put star in front of the count pointer. So this one, count pointer will be a pointer to an integer. And if you want to make the use of pointing this link to this variable count, you have to use count pointer equal to address or ampersand count. And that's all. So if I want to perform dereferencing, what is the dereferencing? Printf what? If you want to get the value by dereference, how can I write the program? Anyone in this room can answer this question? What will I place here as the dereference of the count pointer? If I want to print the value where count pointer points to, let me see the answer. Ampersand star count pointer, no. Ampersand count, no. Okay, would you are correct? Star count pointer. Okay, this one is correct. What I will give you one point for your answer today. Okay, and why? Can you explain me why with this count pointer, star count pointer? we have already studied, right? That is a dereference, dereferencing, right? Dereferencing means to change the pointer of the value, the pointer to the value by using star. That's right. Normally, when we talk about this, right, count pointer, this one is pointer. But if you want to get the value, dereferencing, you can just simply use the asterisk or star sign. And that's all. You can get the value at the count pointer. So what is the value? What is the value that will be printed out? In this example, 7, right? That's right. Thank you, Ti. Thank you, Chris. I think Ti is trying to type 7, but sala'u comes out. Okay, thank you very much. Right, this is the what we call the dereferencing, right? This is how to make the use of the pointer. So thinking carefully, right? You are get used to this one, right? Define a variable by using count, and then you assign a value to this variable. So I want you to think in opposite way, right? If you have another variable that is a pointer, right? And you need to point to it, right? Asterisk and pointer, right? And then you can just simply use ampersand here to get the address of the count and then place it or assign it to the count pointer. And this is, if you understand this page clearly, you understand the concept, all concept about the pointer. Okay, this one is a more explanation about the pointer definition. You can use asterisk, star sign in order to declare the pointer variable, right? If you want to declare pointer of integer, right, you can use like this, right? Remember, right? You can also have multiple pointers like star pointer 1, star pointer 2, right? And then you can initialize it to null or to 0. If you declare it and you need to initialize it, firstly, you can also use 0. Or you can use a type of a defined variable now. Right now is also equal to 0. For example, you can, if you write the integer my pointer like this, and then you can write my pointer 1 is equal to now. Okay, this is an initialization of the pointer, right? Right, this is an initialization in it. Initialization. Okay, next. You also have the pointer operator, ampersand, S-A-N-D, and sign, right? If you declare int y is equal to 5, and then a pointer star y pointer, right? And then you want to point y pointer to this value y, so you can use address y. Normally, I am not going to call this autopronounces ampersand. I will call it address of y. So it makes sense, okay? It makes sense that y pointer gets address of y, address of y. Or we can say that y pointer, ypr point to y. Okay, let me write it. Y pointer point to the variable y. Y is allocated in the memory. Okay, something like this. Do you get the point? Do you understand? If you all understand, I will skip to the next page. That is a pointer operator. Okay, this is a tangible things, right? Tangible value that about how to explain about the pointer operators. Okay, if you could remember, we have just already, okay, we declare y as a variable, right? And 5 is a value inside the variable. And we also declare a pointer ypgr, that is a pointer to an integer. And then if I use yptr is equal to ampersand y, right? So this pointer will point to here. So y pointer will point to the address of y. What does it mean? Okay, in the memory location 66, okay, like this is the memory location y, and y is equal to 5. 5 will be stored in this memory. But yptr was declared in another location, right? Okay, let's say 500,000, for example. But when you use a statement like this, yptr is equal to address of y. So what does it mean? Y is here, right? But address of y is the value 6,100. Okay, so now ampersand y is 600,000. Okay, so 600,000 will be placed to this value of yptr. Even the location is 5,100. Do you understand? Okay, I think this picture is quite clear about the pointer operator and the relationships between the y and y pointer. Okay, you have to remember or you have to understand this page. This page is very important. Okay, maybe I have to put the star sign. 1, 2, 3. Three stars means important. Okay, you have to understand about this one. Okay, maybe I have to write something like integer y. Integer yptr, and then yptr is equal to address of y. Okay, maybe you have to know the meanings of these three statements or the meaning or the relationship between these three statements. Okay. So pointer operators, we have indirect or dereferencing operator. The dereferencing operator will return a synonym or areas of what its operand points to. For example, asterisk or star y pointer returns y because y pointer points to y. Okay, star can be used for assignment, right? If you want to assign a value 7 to asterisk y pointer, you can use this. So it also will change the value of y to 7. That's why we call indirect dereference. Okay, let me show you, okay, this one. We have y, right? And you also have y pointer that point to the value to like this. Okay, this one is 500,000 and this one is at the 600,000. Actually, this one keep 600,000. And then, okay, in the first place, y is equal to 5. But if I use this figure, right? So at this, y pointer means address that y pointer points to. The address that y pointer points to is 600, right? That point to here. And then this is the address of 600,000. And then when you put asterisk in front of the y pointer, this is the y pointer, okay? But when you use the asterisk in front of the y pointer, it means dereferencing or to get the value that y pointer point to, the value that y pointer point to okay, we assign 7 to this. So 7 will be here. This one. Asterisk Y pointer is assigned by 7. So you need to explain or you need to encrypt. What does it mean? This one is a pointer, right? This one is the value at pointer points to. The value that this pointer yptr, right, point to is this address, right? So 7 assigned to this, so 7 will assign to this. So understand? So that's why it's called indirect. Because if you want to assign the value to this memory, so you can just use y is equal to 7. But if you want, this is direct assignment, but if you want to use indirect mean you have to use the pointer. The pointer of y is yptr, right? But the value of that pointer point to is star yptr. Is equal to 7. These two statements are equal, are equivalent. Okay. So this is an example of pointer operators. Okay, so in the main, integer main void, right? A is an integer. A pointer is a pointer to A, right? We are going to point to A. So we assign A is equal to 7. Now A is equal to 7. A is here. And then A pointer is here. Just stay. So A is equal to 7. So now A is 7. A pointer is equal to address of A. So here is point to A. I like this as the meaning, the visual meanings of A pointer is equal to address A, right? But actually it is the address of A, suppose it is FFFF. So I will put FFFF to here. Even the address of APGR is EEEE. Okay, I use the hexadecimal because I want to discriminate between the exact value or the constant value of integer with discriminate with the address. When I write it in a hexadecimal, it can, in some sense, it's like to refer to the address in main memory. Okay, let's say like that. Okay, so here we are to the line 11. And then we are trying to print out the value 7. If we want to print out the address, so we can use either address A, or A pointer itself, because A pointer is itself an address. This one is an address, right? And if you want to get the address of A, you can use address A, right? A pointer points to A, and then address A and A pointer have the same value. This one is important. And then if we want to print out the value of that location, so you can also use A itself that is available, or A pointer, but you put star in front of. So A and star A pointer have the same value, that is 7. Okay, it seems like someone someone is trying to, if you could remember, as Amazon, Sata, and Pointer, right? We are going to mix between this one. Okay, this is also showing that Sata and Amazon are complement of each other. So this one, we are trying to print out the address, right? Can use a pointer itself is an address. So this one is like a complement of each other. So you use address and this one, it will be eliminated. Or you use star and then asterisk, it will be eliminated. So in this one, so this one is actually is a pointer. And this one is a pointer as well. So this one is trying to, okay, they are the same value. Okay. So this one, Amazon and Sata are opposite value. Okay, do you get the point? Okay, this is an example of, this is an example output here. Okay, so print address, it will be the same, right? Print the value 7, the same. Okay, and showing Amazon and asterisk are components of each other. So it will print out the address, which is the same. You can see that the address will be referred to as a segment and offset 00 to 8 and FECO. Called segment and offset. Okay, the next topic we have already studied last time, right? About call function by references. And I'm going to review you about it again, okay? A bit again. Okay, we are going to use call by reference in the sense that suppose we want to return the value back. For example, if you consider this function double, right? And you get star number, right? So this is a pointer. This one is a pointer, okay? So if you use it as a pointer, so you have to use this in order to refer to it as the value. So if you want to change the value in the name of number, right? You can use to multiply by address number, right? And then this is the double of this number. And then when you call it in the main function, double, you have to send n ampersand number like this. And then the number NO here will be changed to number multiplied by 2. Okay, let's think about this one, the pass by value of cube by value. If you want to calculate the cube of the cubic mean n less to the power 3, right? For example, if you have the argument n, right? So if you turn n multiplied by n multiplied by n, that is a cube, right? N less to the power 3. This is cube by value. So if you use cube by value, when you use the number 3, it will return 3 less to the power 3, for example. Okay, or this one, 5, where you return 125. But for pass by reference, right, you don't have to return anything. You use Q by reference, and then you want to return the value by asterisk, or this is an address NPTR. So if you want to do this, right, when you pass, you have to pass a value by address number, okay, and number. Don't forget to put this. You put and because you want to pass the number to this one. The actual parameter we pass to the formal parameter in Q by reference function, and then this one you multiply by this one and this one, right? So you get NPTR raised to the power 3, and then the result will be assigned to asterisk NPTR. And then this one will assign to this, and this one will go to number, which is the address that this number points to. So the result will be the number, right? The number has been changed inside the cube by reference function. Okay, this is why we call reference, class by reference, or reference is equal to address, or we can call class by address. Okay, this figure will be the step by step of class by value when you are trying to use the cube by value. And the next page will be the pass by reference when you are trying to use the function cube by reference. Okay, so you can do the step by step, and then you can understand, you can look for it, then you can understand about the concept of pass by reference, or sometimes it is a pass by pointer or address. We can use the word pointer and address interchangeably. Okay, before we go to the next topic, right, I'm going to give you 10 minutes back, right? And then we'll come back and talk again about the concept of the pointers at 11:30. Okay. Okay, the next topic that we are going to talk or to understand about it, which is using the consent quantifier with pointer. Sometimes we can use the modifier constant, right? The qualifier constant in order to make the variable cannot be changed, or the static, to be the static. If you want to make it to be static, right, you have to use the constant qualifier, right? The value cannot be changed. Cannot be changed. Use constant if function does not need to change a variable. Okay, or we attempt to change the constant variable can produce an error. Okay, maybe we can see the example. Okay, we can also define a constant, my pointer to be a constant, to fix or to point to the address X always. So if you use a constant pointer like this, so it means that the my pointer, right, will fix. I use the purple one, right, to show that this will be fixed to the address of X. The purple one means fixed or static, or that's why we call constant. Constant means it cannot be changed. It cannot be changed. So sometimes we want to use to make the use of my pointer to point to always point to X, right? Otherwise, it will cause an error. Okay. So this is an example of how to convert a string to uppercase. So this one is we are going to show the function convert to uppercase, right? So we can have the character here, right? Character is a pointer to character. This is a pointer to character. And we fix the character setting to be like this. And then we print out the string, and then we convert every lowercase to the uppercase, right? And up for the uppercase character, it will remain the same. So if you print this by using string, right? This function is to convert to uppercase. So let us go to the function convert to uppercase. Okay. Okay. This function maybe it is quite a bit difficult, right? Or a bit complicated because we use the pointer. So you can see that this one is a pointer, right? Not equal to backslash zero. What does it mean by this, right? When you go to the function convert to uppercase, and I'm going to implement this one in a Jiffy. Okay, so we use while loop, right? While loop, asterisk, it means that the current character is not equal to backslash zero, which is the end of string. Backslash \0 means the end of string. Or sometimes for the abbreviation, it is EOS. EOS, end of string. Okay, and we have to use to make the use of toUpper. toUpper is a function, right, that will convert from, let's say, small a to capital A, or capital A itself, it remains the same, for example. Okay, so we will have to use the S. Okay. Why we can use? Because the character is just the array of character, right? We can define a string as an array of character, let's say 20 for something like this, right? Why we can just compare only this one. Okay, I'm going to talk about this, and then we use plus S pointer. It means that to move to the next character. I'm going to explain this function for the expert programmer, C programmer, okay? So if you don't understand, don't be afraid of it. Okay, I'm going to come back about this and explain to you again. But I will show you the simpler version of this function, okay? But today, now I'm going to explain to the not beginners programmers. Okay, so for the first while loop, right, we have to check whether the current character is \0. And then you have to, for the current character, right? Current character here, we can use, okay, let me think like this. Okay, suppose we have SPTR is a string, right? Something is equal to A, B, C, D, something like this, right? Okay, so the first, when I use asterisk str, SPTR, right? So this one is a pointer, right? SPTR is a pointer. So for a string, pointer will point to the first character of the string for the first time. For the first time, X will point to the address of A, the address of the character A, right? So when we use asterisk star S, it will return character A, capital A. So capital A will substitute to this one, and then we use the function toUpper to convert A to capital A, capital A to capital A. So the first character will be not changed, remain the same. And then plus S pointer. Plus S pointer is also an operator of the pointer. This one means to move from the current character to the next character, which is B, small b. So now small b is here. So the small b will convert to capital B. And then capital B will be changed here. And then we move to the next one. This is the plus S pointer, right? So we move to here, to C. And C will be toUpper, and then place to the same location. So C will change to capital C, and so on. This is the way that the convert to uppercase does. So this is the function to convert from, let's see this example. Characters will combine with small letter and capital letter, right? And then we will all set to capital letter, right? Characters, okay? But for digits, there is no change to the toUpperCase function, okay? This is the function that we are going to implement this today, okay? And the next one, this one is a function that we use to print a string character, right? By using constant string, right? Okay, we have to put this one, and then we use for loop here, right? And print each character onto the screen. Okay, so you can see that print character, right? The argument that we will receive from this argument is asterisk c, s pointer, right? And then we use constant in order to be the qualifier for the fixed string here. And we use loop for, right, instead of while, right? For the previous example, we use the loop while for checking each character. For in this case, we use the loop, the for loop, in order to check for each character as well. So the you can see that the first argument can be ignored, right? If you don't have the initialization part in the for loop. But you need to check for the end of string character, which is \0, right? And then you can use plus s pointer to move forward each character after you finish printing out the character. In this for loop, right, inside the for loop, we can just simply use only print one character, right, from the current position of s pointer position. So we can think about the string, right? This because this one is an array of character, right? Pointer of character, right? This one is equal to the array of character. Array of character is also the string, right? So this is the relationships between the pointer to character, array of character, and the string. So that's why we do not have the data type, string data type in C programming, because we can make the use of the pointer or array of character to solve the problem of using C, using string. Okay, do you get the point? I think you can make it to understand about this clearer, right? You have to write the program, okay? And this one is an array or the pointer to an integer, right? So you can also use this one. Okay, and for the next example will be the some example of how to make the use of the pointer in many applications. For example, if you want to sort a list of integer by using the pass by reference, or you have to use the bubble sort, right? I'm going to talk about this later. So today I would like to show you how to implement this one. Okay. Okay, let me try to show you about how to write a program to make the understand of how to use the pointer. Okay, for the pointer, maybe you have to start from in A, right? Okay, and then if you want to declare a pointer to an A, you can use a PTR, right, integer. But if you want to make it to be a pointer, P-O-I-N-T-R to A, pointer to A, you have to use Star. Okay, this is a declaration for the pointer. Okay, so if we assign A to 7, I suggest you to try to type, even you understand about the concept of the pointer, I still suggest you to write the program by yourself so you can get used to it. And then you have to write it as many as possible. Okay, and if you want to use a PTR to point to the address of A, how can we do? APTR will be assigned with what? If I want to use APTR to point to A, APTR to point to the address of A. Address of A means ampersand, right? Ampersand is the address of A. Right, so now I use ampersand A here. Address of A, right? Direct meanings. So I want to print out the address of A. Okay, the value of A. The value of A is percent sign A. It's percent sign A. Percent sign D. Okay, / N, and then we print A. Okay, the value of A is supposed to be 7. Okay, so 7 will be printed out. The value of A is 7. That's all right. And if we want to print the address of A, okay, this is the direct, the address or the value of A, the address of A is what? Is ampersand A, right? Normally, if you want to print the pointer, you use percent sign P, okay? And run. Okay, this is the address of A, right? Hexadecimal 7FFE6BB95 and so on. Okay, this is simple. This is the way that you always do, right? You always do. So, but if you want to do dereferencing, you want to find the value of APTR. The value of APTR means the address of APTR, right? Now APTR is point to address A, right? P APTR. Right, so it will be the same address, right? You see, the value of APTR, right? It is the same as the address of A. That A is A points to APTR points to. Okay. And then the value, dereferencing. Dereferencing means to get dereferencing. Do you remember the word dereferencing of pointer? It means that to get the value where the A pointer points to, right? So it will be value D, right? And then it will be dereferencing means star. Star A, okay? So this one is the referencing or indirect value of A pointer. A pointer is a pointer. The address at A pointer is star A pointer will be equal to 7. Do you understand the point? I paste this program to the group, okay? Okay, thank you very much for your answer and percent A, right? From Nat, from Bill, from Chris, right? That is a correct, right, result. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think this one is very simple concept for the pointer. I hope all of you will. Yes, T. Okay, you are confused about the last one, right?
Why? Yes, I confused.
Why APTR is return the 7, right? Because it is the dereferencing. What does it mean by dereferencing? When we have a pointer, right? Okay, so in this way, you can go to the page number, the page number 9. You can see that for the value, you can think about y as RS to A, okay? First, A is a variable, right? And the value of A is 7. And A pointer is a pointer that points to an integer, and then we set to the address of A, right? Address of A. So it means that when A is 6,000, right? And Y pointer or A pointer will be, the value of Y pointer will be 600,000, right? So you are going to say that why the result here is not 600,000, am I right? Why it is 7? Tanakit, am I right? What do you think the value was to be printed out? The address, right?
You can go back
to the third line, A pointer. If you use just only A pointer, the value or the address of that pointer will be printed out. The value of A pointer kept is the A pointer stores is this address. But when you use star, right? So it means that you have to get the value where the address points to. So in this case, A pointer point to where? In this case, A pointer point to address of A, am I right?
Yes.
Okay. What is the value where A pointers, where A stores? What is the value where A stores? What is the value 7. Of A? 7. Yes. That's why the 7 will be printed out. This concept is called dereferencing or indirect accessing, indirect value. Indirect in the sense that direct is A point to A stores 7, but A pointer is a pointer on the address of A. Okay, let's think like this. Do you have the dormitory room or do you stay in your room at house, at your home?
You ask me or?
Yes, I ask you.
I stay at home.
Okay, you stay at home, you have your own room, right?
Yes.
Okay, so your own room will name as A. What is the value? What is the value will be stored in your room? Yourself, right?
Yourself, me, yes. Oh. Yeah,
yourself. Okay, so what does it mean by the value of your room?
It's me.
Yes, right. What is the address of your room? Of A, of yourself. What is the address of yourself?
It's room number.
It's your home address or the name of your room, right? Okay, so the value of A pointer. Okay, you understand that. And then when I say that, I would like to put the bomb to your bedroom, who will die?
Again, put a line up.
I want to put a bomb into your room. Who will die?
Oh.
Your room will die or yourself?
Both.
Both. Okay. So this is why I call it dereferencing. A pointer is your room. and star is, what is the value that stored in your room or in your in a pointer? That is you. Okay, let me change. When I change your room or your bedroom, I change the value to me. What is the value of A? Ajahn, right? Teacher, right? And then when you put the bomb to your room, who will die? I will die. I mean the value, okay, has been changed. But if I want you to die, so I will change the address to the constant. So I have to fix that you have to be in your room, and then I will put the bomb. Okay, this is a good example, right?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, how about the others? Do you get the point? If I give you a dangerous, no, not a dangerous. Okay, let it go. Okay, so I think you all, I hope you all, can you explain about the constant again? Okay, in this case, if I use a pointer to be the address of A, right? This is a variable. Okay, let me change. Natcha, the same as my name. Okay, let's have the B, integer B, and B is A. Okay, A pointer to A, and if I change my mind, A pointer change to B. Okay, so now the value of A pointer will change to address of B, right? You can see that address of A is 1668, right? And B, address of B is 60, but A pointer is 60 because we can change the value. So this one is not the constant. But if you want to change this to constant, str constant, I'm not sure about this one. Okay. Run. Still change. We can also change the address. I will die if I get a bomb, right? Yeah. I don't know who will be in that room, but the star APTR means who is in that address will die because of the bomb. Okay, that means the value 7. Okay, for the case of constant, it means that if you assign the value to that constant value, or let's say if you want to fix the address to point to the address of A all the time of the program execution, so we can use the constant. So during the compilation and the execution time, the value will not be changed if you use the constant modifier. I'm not sure whether I explained to Natcha correct. You understand what I'm talking about? Okay, thank you very much. So I will skip to the next the next example, that is the to convert a string to uppercase, because this one you may confused about it. Okay, let's start from the main first. Can we use standard.io.h, and we can also use the include C type when we want to use the uppercase, right? We have to use C type. And then we have a character string, right? So we want that what to fix about the length of the string, we can use the blank bracket like this. And then we use KMUTTCPE, okay? And then dollar sign. Pound sign one. Okay, you are CPE 36, right? This is your batch, right? Okay, this is the not the chat, it is to be character. This say character, not character, okay. Okay, you use print F-I-T, print F, and then person sign S. And backslash N, and I print out string. And then I convert to upper. Case, I change this string, right? And then print the thing. Normally, when you want to convert something or you want to change the value here, normally you will use ampersand, right? When you change the value of something, right, in the function, right? And then you want to get the new value back to this value string, right? You need to use the ampersand. But this is a special case, right? Array of character, you can use it as it is the pointer. So you don't have to put address here. And then what we will do next? Okay, to make it easier, I use void here. Uppercase character, right? You can see that when you pass array of character here, and then when I receive, I can use PSPTR like this, or I can use star, they are the same, okay? In this case, I will think about the setting as an array of characters, so I will type like this. And then I use while loop. Okay, I have to use I equal to 0, I have to set start from the 0, okay? And then y, sptr, I, right? Is not equal, not is exclamation mark, and then equal, not equal to now something or backslash 0. Then something to upper sptri is equal to upper to sptri. Okay, and then I plus, okay. I use this one. Okay, let me start to run. Okay, so when the original CPE small letter, right, it will be changed or convert to upper, to big, to capital CPE, KMUTT CPE 36, right? So this one, you can use this one in the to change with the function convert to upper in the slide. Okay, this one is easier, right? It's convert to upper, right? Or if you want to convert to lower, so I use to lower. Okay, let me change to lower. Okay, and then I run. So every characters, every single character from this string will be changed to the lower character. Okay, do you get the point? So let's come back. Let's come back to the previous lab, right? I want you to compare to string, right? To string. So I will use integer, right? Compare string. I use compare string. Okay, there are two string, right? So I write. S1 and S2. An integer I. So what shall I do? So I do the same thing, right? Instead of comparing until reach to the end of character like this, so you have to Y. S1 I. Now to start from the initialize I to the first character, right? I is equal to 0 means the first character for each is setting. The first character of two strings are compared. Right, we'll set initialize to 0, and then Y S1 is not equal to S2. Okay. So in this case, I have to check why they are equal to each other. Then I pass, right? Compare mean to check why still equal to 0 or why each character of two strings are the same character. So what shall we do? Okay, we have to move on. We have to move on. That is iPad plus. If not, if not return false, return false means 0. But in case of string compare, if they are all match, if two string S1 and S2 are equivalent, it will return 0. Otherwise, it will return 1 or 2. So in this case, right? What are the cases when the program will exit from the while loop? The first one is when S1 I and S2 I are not the same. If they are not the same, then I will return what? I will return the character. This is the concept of the string compare, okay? They will make the minus, right? Make the subtraction S1i, the character of the S1i with subtracts with the S2i, right? If this one is big A and the first one is B, the second one is B, right? if the first two characters that are not met, it will return minus one. Am I right? And else return zero. There are two cases when we will go out of this loop. We will go out of this loop when S1 and S2 are not equal. If they are not equal, we will return the differences, the difference between two characters. Otherwise, they reach to the end of string, right? So we return zero. Okay, so we have two string. Character setting two. Okay, we have to check for the if compare setting. To string str string and string two, right? If compare string printf print the same. If I like, suppose I like this, if compare string else. Else I print not match. So in this case, we are going to print not match, right? But it print out the same. The reason why it's print out the same because string compare match will return zero. This one is not match. But it's not matched, right? It's not return zero. So if it's true, so it will print the same. So you have two ways to solve this problem. The first one is compare string is equal to zero. See, equal to zero, it means it's matched. Okay, it's equal to zero and I run. It will say not matched. Okay, or this is tricky. Right, this one may be too long for you, right? So I use not string compare. This is a professional C programmer do, right? Not string compare, right? If you return the same, okay, not match. If I want to ignore the cases, right? For this example, I write string two, string is lowercase, right? And then string two, I use two lower. I use this to lower, so I use back to upper. Before we will go, right? Okay, I would like you to check for the class attendance by type 9. Okay, but before you will go, right? This one is a program that I give you, right? But I need you to I want you to write a new to uppercase, right? This one convert to uppercase, you will return void. Okay, but I want you to return the string. How can we do? How can we do? My homework is from the slide pointer, right? I will ask you to try to type each program, right? And see whether you understand about the program or not, okay? So for my homework now, it's just to try to type every single program in this slide, and then try to understand about this. For example, understand the size of the bubble sort, right? So do you think you can do that? Okay. I hope you can do that.